what we want to talk about today in our little short 15 minutes, or how much we now have, is we want to give you a little bit a peep into how we work, the methods, and how design research is conducted. We use a lot of methods. Role play is also one of them, but we also use a method called probing. Oh, yeah, Taxina. And we want to demonstrate this probe for you and how it works. Before we are doing this, it is also obviously that there's a lot of questions going before this. Some of the questions that we have asked ourselves is, what does it mean to be, what does empowering mean? Or what does it mean to be empowered as a patient, as a cancer patient? Some of the questions that we have asked ourselves is that what is it that makes you what makes you stronger in such a hard situation, and what makes you weak? And there's a lot of yes. So we have been trying to map out and to think about what are the networks on the social relations and the people who are around you that can empower you? Can it be things or rituals or certain beliefs that you have? Or are there certain situations that empowers you during this during your treatment or a period of cancer? And this is a little bit the questions that go, let's say, before the design of the probe. Okay. Probing, I mean, Not that I want to make a long story, but it's a very, very well-known method within participatory design. It has been used a lot, and it's a different way of having a dialogue or conducting an interview, because you use small assignments. And as Peter just said, that these assignments can be in a package that you kind of send out to the people that you are designing for. But it can also be participatory. That's a little bit more what me and Sina are doing. So we are actually not sending it out. We are going out there and we are having a probe session together with the patient. Yeah. But let's dive into the probe. What you see in front of you is actually three assignments. One that me and Sina has called mapping. That's the assignment in the probe that takes the longest time. Then we have a second assignment over here, which in Danish is called hårknuderne. And then we have a third assignment here, which is about characteristics, yes. We will use most time on this one and shortly go through the two other ones. But let's start with the first one. These islands represent feelings. So for instance, you have the earthlings, jordboerne in Danish. What we are asking here is what or who gives you tranquility and presence, ro og nærvær in Danish. Then we have an island called the drones. Where do we have it here? In the middle, the drones. And that has to do with things that give you overview and control. We have a third island, which is called overskuddene in Danish, the energizers up here. And here we are asking into what gives you surplus energy, overskud in Danish. Another island here, which we have called the enemies, where we ask to who or what makes you fear or makes you feel powerless. Afmagt it is in Danish. This one is called in Danish vandhanerne. We didn't have a good translation for that one, so we have called the drains. And that has to do with what gives you space for grief or relief or sorrow. And a last island here, which in Danish is called grinebiderne, impossible to translate. So we have called it the gigglers. And that has to do, deals with joy and pleasure. Okay, and now is it that you really have to hang on to it? So we're going to explain this through a patient called, yes, a case, Annette. She's a cancer patient and she's 65 years old. She's the mother of three and she's a journalist. And here we have to ask her to place on each island. For instance, if we take jordboerne, the earthlings, what things or people or activities makes you feel tranquil and gives you presence. And for instance, Annette, she placed on this island, she placed her sofa that gives her presence. She placed her Sudoku. She placed people who are in the same situation as she are. She placed her husband, and she placed film. She saw a lot of film. And what me and Tina is then trying to do as we go along is that all these things represent different categories. All the green ones here are things and objects. All the yellow ones are people. This one, the gray ones, is all that has to do with media. And so we have different categories to all her answers that we are trying to kind of categorize. Yeah? So let's take one more island, the enemies.
We asked her who or what she hated throughout her treatment, and she asked or answered that chemo was her biggest enemy. It helped her as well, but it was her biggest enemy. It was a struggle for her. And then she chose her caseworker. It had something to do with getting money while you couldn't work, and that had been a struggle for her, so it really took a lot of energy from her in this period. And then the last one was those who speak as if she is going to die. She said that the look of people's faces when they came to her in the supermarket, for example, they looked so sad, and she felt maybe okay, but that meeting was very hard. The energizers. So on the other hand, we have the people who gives her energy. That is people whom she can have good and wise conversations with. Then she told us self-spoilment. She hadn't been good at that before, but she became better throughout the treatment. And unexpected care. She said there was a lot of experiences where people came to her and gave her a flower and she didn't even know them, and that was really a positive experience. And then at last she had a makeup course. Before she didn't really use makeup, but when all her hair fell off, then she really felt that it gave her a good tool for her to feel to stay positive.
So what you have to understand here is that we sit with Annette, and together we are trying to map out all these connections that are between certain emotions and the things she is surrounded about with, and the people she is surrounded with, and in that way we create a mapping. What this probe doesn't show is the why the sofa, the why the film, the why my husband, and that we are mapping using the film, that we are recording everything, and we are mapping also the whys, but it's not in the probe. Yes, so this is the mapping part. We brought one more assignment from the probe, and this is assignment called Hårknuderne, and the purpose with this assignment is to get a little bit more grip of what are the very most difficult thing to solve or to handle or to get over. And here we used knots. So we gave Annette five, how do you say that, empty knots. And we asked her to use keywords to define what were the hardest things to solve or to deal with. And as you can see here, she put on here fear, angst, it says here in Danish. Yes, exactly, yes. Is it angst in German? Okay. Yes. She puts chemo, side effects of chemo, yes. And even though she was over the chemo, she still suffered from that. She mentioned economy here, and this she labeled with this knot. She mentions sex life. She mentioned children. But what's very obviously when we started to graduate it, that the very hard things were these two, was chemo side effects and fear. And this one she labeled as the most impossible one to solve. Uløselig voldsom. Sorry, I didn't translate that one. Unsolvable. Angst, because, and there she explained that she's always afraid that it's going to come back. So she cannot solve this one. And this one she labeled difficult to solve. And with the three other ones, she said that here you will find a way somehow.
She chose the different nuts because this is big and fluffy, and that reminded her of the anxiety and also the chemo side effects. That was a little hard one, like she wouldn't really get rid of it. So she is materializing her thoughts about the different problems, and that is a part of the assignment.
Here we asked Annette to think about. First, she had a whole amount of labels that deals with characteristics. It says actually there's an English one. Oh, doesn't matter. It's the Danish one. Okay, but it says skeptical. It says proactive, optimistic, loyal, patient, grateful, tolerant. And many more. And we said to her if she could place, and she could also make new ones, if she could think about her as a person before she got to know that she had cancer and afterwards. So here she said that before she got cancer, she was more temperamental, she was more critical, and she was skeptical. And after she got the cancer, she mentioned a lot of things. She said she has become more grateful. She was less patient in relation to processes. She was becoming much more in the need of being spoiled. She had become more proactive, more positive, less tolerant towards whining. She simply hated when people talked about their chickens running away or problems they had with their children, because that was just small problems, she said. And as she was really negotiating, putting things, putting them back and forth, and then she agreed on with herself that this was the picture. Yes. Good.
And I think we made this assignment. We made this assignment because we wanted to know if people saw themselves as positive people or like skeptical people, or to understand their answers in this assignment.
Some of you might probably wonder, how do we then analyze this and how can we go along with this? But it is also a big work. We get a lot of information out of one probe session. But what we are doing right now is that we are trying to analyze the probe. Sorry, it's not such a good, because it's a huge drawing, this one. But what you can see is that it's like a matrix. On the top, we have all the islands, the earthlings, the drones, and so forth. And down on the other X, we have all the categories here. And in that way, we can see, okay, we get an overview, okay, what people is connected to these islands, or what kind of objects are important to her. And in that way, we can make different connections. So our next thing is, now we are conducting these probe studies here. From the knowledge that comes out of this, we hope to get more clear answer to what things, people and interaction makes you strong and what makes you weak, or what weakens you, and what are the hardest things to overcome, and how does cancer somehow, or does cancer change you, or how does it change you? And the knowledge from this is actually used to inform the next probe study then. Yes, okay, I hope that was clear. Okay, thank you.